The orders of the court are: 1. Leave to appeal is granted with respect to ground 1 only, and the appeal is dismissed. I will now read a summary. By a majority of 2-1, the Court of Appeal has dismissed Cardinal George Pell's appeal against his conviction for the commission of sexual offences. He will continue to serve his sentence of 6 years imprisonment. He will remain eligible to apply for parole after he has served 3 years and 8 months of his sentence. Whether Cardinal Pell will be released on parole will be a matter for the Adult Parole Board, not the courts. Before describing in summary form why the court has reached the decision it has, there is some relevant context of note. Last year, Cardinal Pell was convicted of 5 specific sexual offences alleged to have been committed on 2 occasions in the mid-1990s when he was the Catholic Archbishop of Melbourne. In a previous trial on the same charges, the jury were unable to reach a verdict. Cardinal Pell's position is that he should not have been convicted. Cardinal Pell's conviction and this appeal have attracted widespread attention, both in Australia and beyond. He is a senior figure in the Catholic Church and is internationally well known. As the trial judge, Chief Judge Kidd, commented when sentencing Cardinal Pell, there has been vigorous and sometimes emotional criticism of the Cardinal, and he has been publicly vilified in some sections of the community. There has also been strong support for the Cardinal by others. Indeed, it's fair to say that this case has divided the community. It is important to stress at the outset that Cardinal Pell's conviction only concerns the 5 offences alleged to have been committed by him. Again, as the trial judge observed, he is not to be made a scapegoat for any perceived failings of the Catholic Church, nor for any failure in relation to child sexual abuse by other clergy. His conviction and sentence could not be a vindication of the trauma by other victims of sexual abuse. The offences in respect of which Cardinal Pell was found guilty by a county court jury were 1 charge of sexual penetration of a child under 16 and 4 charges of indecent act with a child under 16. The trial lasted for 5 weeks. The jury deliberated for several days. The jury's verdict was unanimous. Each of us has watched recordings of the evidence given by 12 of the 24 witnesses at the trial. We have also watched recordings of the view the jury were taken on, the walkthrough
Thank you.
Well, right, clearly technical issues there.
Yes, which is a pity, but we do know now what the result is.
Absolutely. The court has decided by a 2-1 majority to dismiss George Pell's application for his appeal, which means he's lost. He gets to stay in prison now, as the Chief Justice Anne Ferguson pointed out, to continue his 6 years imprisonment. Until he's eligible for parole, that's not until near the end of 2022. This is a major blow for George Pell and his supporters. They had their hopes pinned on the finding that the jury couldn't have found him guilty. That was their biggest hope, that the Court of Appeal would find that the jury could not have found, beyond reasonable doubt, that he did molest those 2 schoolboys back in the 1990s. And yet, as you can see now, there are lots of people there who are outside the court who are waiting for this decision. Those are representatives of survivors and survivors groups. Christina Hearn, you're there now. What reaction are you getting?
Well, Brett, there was a big cheer that went up here outside the Supreme Court when news filtered through that appeal had been dismissed. I'm here with Michael. You're a very well-known survivor advocate. Michael, what is the feeling now that you know that George Pell is going back behind bars to serve out the rest of his sentence?
Oh, look, it's absolutely outstanding news. So we can now officially say bar a High Court appeal, and no doubt Pell, he's a master at using every legal tactic there is, but we can now comfortably say Pell is a criminal, Pell is a pedophile, Pell is a destroyer and a maimer of young children. He's a pathetic human being, a pig of a man, and we are elated. Look, 3 years and 8 months we can live with. That's his non-parole period. I'd also like to say I think it's outrageous that he's been able to receive fan mail of up to 2,000 letters while he's there. Prison isn't a retreat. Prison isn't a holiday. Prison isn't a process where, you respond to your fan mail.
Michael, can I just ask, were you anxious today? Because obviously there was the possibility that George Pell could be walking free today. Describe what it's been like for you and others. The advocates today and the relief that you now feel?
Look, it's been truly a nightmare. I had a victim on the phone to me last night at 7:40, just in tears, couldn't talk for the first 5 minutes. Our relief is phenomenal.
Hi YouTubers, I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at 9news.com.au.